Let's talk about logic. Whenever you're doing programming, logic is really important. Logic's important in other ways too, but for programming, that's like what we actually care about. So we can do logic. We have and, or, nots, and exclusive ors, and that's what we're gonna look at. So first of all, we start out with and. And is an ampersand. And if you say and, like, that means you have to meet both requirements. So say that, like, if you think about like Venn diagrams, then that's what you get like in the middle. So if you have a group of people who like puppies and you have a group of people who like kitties, then the group in the middle would be the group of the people who like puppies and kitties. So that's and. I have to like kitties and I also have to like puppies in order to be into this group. So I'm totally cool. Okay, so in logic, you might say something like, we live on Earth, we eat radishes. So we say P would be we live on Earth and Q would be we eat radishes. And so these are both true statements. We are living on Earth and incapable of eating radishes. So if I say we live on Earth and we eat radishes, then that is a true statement because both are true. We live on Earth and we also eat radishes. So I've said a true statement. So we can say that P and Q is true. If I say though, we live on Earth and we eat plutonium, since P is true but Q is false, if I say we live on Earth and we eat plutonium, then that is a false statement. Does that make sense? So if I lie once, if I use and, I'm insisting that they absolutely both must be true, which is clearly not true, so it's false. So we say that P and Q is false. So true and false would be false. Now, two wrongs don't make a right, so if I say we live on Mars and we eat plutonium, it's still false. So just because I lied twice, that's not any better. So we live on Mars and we eat plutonium, still false, false and false is false. So we have this truth table, and you're going to see these a lot. It's pretty common. So we could say that true and true, if both statements are true, true and true is going to be a true statement. True and false would be a false statement. False and true would be a false statement, and false would be a false statement. So there. Now, disjunction is OR. This is the little bar thingy. It's like shift key over your enter sign, probably. I think some people call it a pipe. If you're thinking about Venn diagrams or whatever, it means that you can meet one or other of the requirements, but you don't have to meet both. You can, but you don't have to. So that would be what an OR looks like literally filling the whole thing in. So if you have the group of people who like puppies and the group of people who like kitties, then A or B would be the people who like puppies or kitties or both. So you kind of like think like and is like the really, really demanding person who's like, no, you have to like kitties and you have to like puppies. But the OR guy is the guy who's just like shrugging his shoulders. He doesn't really care. He just wants you to stop talking and get him a sandwich. And he's like, I don't care. You just have to like something, like puppies or kitties or both or whatever. I just want to move on with my day. Okay, so OR is like the person who's just so sick of arguing and they just want somebody to be happy. As long as somebody's happy, they're cool. But the and is like the super demanding person who's like, no, everybody must like kitties and puppies. So this would relate to programming. So, you know, you could say like, oh, well, if you buy a drive or you spend over $100, you get a discount. So you could say, yeah, you get a discount. It only has to be like one or the other. And that's kind of, you're going to see that a lot in programming. It's a lot of times you need to meet this statement or this statement, but not both. So there. So if we say, well, we live on Earth and I say we eat radishes. Now, both of these statements are true. So if I say we live on Earth or we eat radishes, that's not really saying one or the other, although it might kind of sound like it. It's really not. In logic, what I'm saying is, well, we live on Earth or we eat radishes or both. You know, it's really not a big deal. But we would say that true or true is true. Similarly, if I say we live on Earth or we eat plutonium, who knows? I'm saying either one or the other. So either we live on Earth or we eat plutonium, not either. I shouldn't say either. I could say we live on Earth or we eat plutonium. That is a true statement because at least one of those is true. So I could say true or false is true. If I said we live on Mars or we eat plutonium or nitrogen, I don't know how nitrogen got on there. They're both false. Hurry for cut and paste errors. So I could say we live on Mars or we breathe plutonium. That sounds even worse. This is a false statement because false or false is still false. So we could say true or true is, come on, true or true is true. True or false is still true. false or true is still true, and false or false, so that's still false. So the or statement is a lot more forgiving. It's like, oh, you told me that you love me one time, that's good enough for me. And the and is like, no, you have to tell me constantly. So it's important to remember whenever you're programming that even things like ands and ors and nots, which we'll talk about in a second, actually all have order precedence too. So just like parentheses have precedence over pluses and minuses, and multiplication and division and all that kind of stuff. Negation is actually like pretty much one of the more next important things. We'll talk about negation in a second. But you see that all this stuff happens, and then at the end of the day, then we do like greater thans or equal tos, and then after all of that, then we do ands and ors. So ands and ors really come at the bottom of precedence for operators. An and comes before or, so that's important to note. You all of your ands first, then you do your or. If you're looking at like digital systems and stuff like that, you probably learned that and is like a multiplication and or is kind of like addition. So this should still kind of make sense that you do the multiplication and stuff before you do the addition or stuff. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, don't worry about it because it doesn't matter. Okay, so give these a shot, remembering your order of precedence. So ideally, you want to pause the video and be like, I'm going to learn on my own and independently, and it's going to be amazing. And so go do that. So let's pretend that happened. All right. So remember, ands always go first. So I have true and false. True and false is false. You lie to me once, it's all lies. False or false, that's still false. Okay, so I do this one, and then I do this one. So true and false is false. Or true and false, that's still false. So false or false is still false. Doop de doop de doop de doop. So this here is going to be true or true and false is false, so true or false, there's our first true. True or false is true. All right, then we have true and true. Now we know that true and true is true. True or false is true, yay. False and true, and then true and true are gonna happen first. So false and true, that's false. Or false, or true and true is true. True or false, I could say it in that order. Or sorry, false or false is false. False or true is true. And so that's how I can get those kind of answers. Now, if I want, I can actually go and I can take these into MATLAB, which would be kind of fun. So I can go true and false or false. So if I try to go, is it true? True and false or false? True and false or false? I don't think MATLAB can handle this because it's like, what's true? What's false? So it can't handle that, but what it can try to handle are ones and zeros. Not try to handle it, can handle it very well, ones and zeros. So I have one and zero, or zero, and it comes back as false, which is precisely what we had. So you can go ahead and do all of these in MATLAB as well, just to make sure that your answers are correct. So this way you can make up like a ton of problems for yourself just to practice, because you know it's going to come up again, and actually check your answers to make sure that you have it right. So I have true and false, or true and false. So I have true and false, or true and false. False, exactly what we had. True or true and false. True or true and false. True, is that what we got? Yay, okay, kind of freaked out for a second. True and true or false. True and, oh sorry. True and true, or false is true. True and true or false. Wait, I feel like I just did that. Did I skip something? No, I'm just crazy. False and true or false or true and true. So false and true or false or true and true. True, so yay, look. I know math and stuff, yay. Okay, there we go. All right, so that's great. So there's another way you can mix it up is you can use the negative sign. Well, kind of negative signs. So negation. This is the tilde. This is shift other pinky, the pinky above the tab. And that's going to give you your not false. So not false is true and not true is false. So if you remember our order of precedent, we actually do the negative-y stuff first before we do the ands and the ors. So if we had not false and true, that would actually be true and true, which would equal false. Now, of course, if we have parentheses around it, then, you know, all bets are off. But in general, that's kind of what it looks like. So again, try these, pause the video, give it a shot, see how much of this that you can actually do on your own. And assuming that that's happened, So we would look at this and we'd say, okay, we're going to do all of the parentheses stuff first. We say, not parentheses, all the negation first. So this not true is going to become false. So we have false and false, which is false, or false is still false. This not false is going to become true. So we have true and true, which is true, or true and false, which is false. True or false is true. So true and that, this and that. So true and false is false. False or true is true. And again, it's not a terrible idea to go try this out in MATLAB. So we had not true and false or false. So we had not true and false or false. Comes out to be false. We had true and not false or true and false. So true and not false or true and false. You kind of get in the habit of this. So you can actually type these into MATLAB and test your answers just to kind of see if you're getting what you think you should be going to get. True and not true or not false. True and not true or not false is still true. Yay! This is amazing. It works. So there we go. Now this is something that's pretty unique, kind of unique to programming. Like you might have seen the other stuff in regular logic, but this is kind of unique. This is an exclusive OR, which is only true if one or the other is true, but not both. So this is like the weirdest, pickiest thing ever. It's like, I'll have the ranch, but only if it's on the side, or the pie, but then it's heated, but then the ice cream has to be on the side. And they're like you're just like, what? I don't really understand. Can you just shut up and eat your breakfast or whatever it is you're having for pie and ice cream for breakfast? Anyway, exclusive OR in logic. So if I say we live on Earth and we eat radishes, these are actually both true statements. But if I put an exclusive OR on them, then that means that they're false. If I combine them together, because they're both true, and apparently this like exclusive OR is like just so stupid I can't even talk to him, because if I tell him the truth twice, he gets mad. And there's not actually a special symbol for it. It's just XOR that you would see in MATLAB. So if I said, we live on Earth, exclusive OR, we eat plutonium, it's like, oh yeah, I get it, man. It's like we do one, but not both, you know, and you're like, whatever. So exclusive OR is going to come back as true because exactly one of them is true. Now, if I try to say, we live on Mars, exclusive OR, we eat on plutonium, he's like, no way, man, that's like totally out of it. And so that's like false. So exclusive OR, false and false, is still gonna come back as false. So think about how you would fill this table out. Kind of just your standard issue truth table. So if I do an exclusive OR of true and true, or true, true, then that's going to come back as false. If I do exclusive OR of true, false, it'd be true. Exclusive OR of false, true, would be true. And exclusive OR of false, false, would come back as false. Kind of getting there? Woot! So this is kind of fun. If you want to go do these in MATLAB, you could say exclusive OR of true and true, that's going to come back false. Exclusive OR of true false is going to come back to there. Exclusive OR of false true would come back as true. And exclusive OR of false false is going to come back false. So that's kind of like a little introduction to how that kind of stuff works.